working on all fronts without much sleep back in Ukraine today. And Nadia, things were looking a little bit better, but now not so much.
Oh, hi there. Again, thanks for having me in your show. I'm glad to hear you. Well, what's going on? From one side, it's easier because you do understand that there is no any more troops, Russian terroristic troops on the border of Kyiv, like in Bucha, Irpin, Gostomel. But from another side, there is the Belarusian border, which they are like almost every night we are receiving the news.
So they shifted there, and then Donbas, all these other places where they've been, or Mariupol, right? They're shifting. So you're not getting as much of the nighttime air raid sirens, although you get some, but not like you did say a week ago at your place.
Well, no, it's all day long and all night long, pretty much. So you like a usual alarm, you know.
Part of the daily environment. Now talk about what you did yesterday, because you posted some amazing video. And it's got to disturb any human being who sees this, especially the thing that got me with these cars in Bucha, where they had the people were just fleeing for their lives, and they were mowed down. I mean, it's bullet holes, all these cars, and like just hunting humans. It was just sick and twisted. But you went out there yesterday and posted a lot of the videos on your Facebook. I have it up on mine as well, at Mark Larson Media. Talk about your itinerary. I'm glad you got back safely as well, but what did you see?
Well, yeah, thank you. Well, I pretty often go there, but just yesterday I posted information from, for those who doesn't understand what is that, Bucha and Irpin is very, very close to Kyiv. It's pretty much like you have one big city, San Diego, and then little towns around San Diego. It's kind of big San Diego, yes? Like
yeah,
big Chicago.
Like going to like the Carlsbad or San Clemente and so forth. Same thing.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like 15 kilometers from Kyiv. The city, the most horrible thing which happened there, that when Russian terroristic army got there, they started to fight not just with Russian army or with the Ukrainian army, but they were just really horribly killing people. I cannot post those videos, and you probably saw that, and people were checking on the internet when Russian troops were molested kids and girls, and then they, with the knife, they just wrapped the body of woman horribly, and the man, and all these bodies were all along the road of Bucha. So to imagine that, it's I've never seen anything like that, even in a horror movie. So I just don't understand how the world, one huge problem here, not just Russian terroristic army and not just Putin, but the world. The world doesn't understand the reality of what is going on. When you go to, yesterday I didn't post all pictures from Irpin and Gostomel. I will post it later. The buildings are just, the worst city, you can see the city, and then in a moment the city is fully destroyed, burned out. So I don't know how, when the president of Poland and Lithuania, they got here, they were shocked. When British Boris Johnson, he named himself right now Boris Johnsonyuk, Ukrainian version.
because he actually showed up there. I guess Zelensky thinks that maybe Biden would show up. I don't believe that's going to happen anytime soon. But what about this latest story? I mentioned it at the top here, Nadia. Nadia Vesina is with us in Kyiv, Ukraine. Russian nuclear bomber buzzing Ukraine, and then President Zelensky urging anti-radiation pills. Is that what you're hearing? Is that only a particular spot in the country and some of these hotspots?
Zelensky, what did?
He's urging anti-radiation pills for people to take the, just in case there's nuclear anything, heaven forbid, by Russia.
The first thing that our government is always, we are in a super close contact all the time. And just today I was in the mayor of Kyiv, in his office, talking to him. And our government is always taking care about us. They're always trying to. We have a lot of hubs in the city where you can take medicine, you can take food wherever you need. So they are always informing us what we have to do, what we should to do, or we probably need to do if we want this to do.
So a lot of it is just staying ahead just in case, not knowing or already knowing what Putin would have the ability to do, or even he says that he does. You have to be very, very vigilant on that. And I know that part of this is after the Russian battleship, the Moskva, was sunk by Ukrainians in the Black Sea on Thursday, then you know, obviously Putin comes back to say, well, then take this. So he starts attacking Kharkiv and Lviv and then around your town there in Kyiv. So it's more of the same. It just gets more intense in certain areas. And
well,
the devastation is unbelievable to see when you showed that.
Well, what I was trying to tell before, this is Putin is guilty in all what he does, but the world is also guilty in all this. The world doesn't help Ukraine that much because they don't feel all the tragedy. They want us to fight with Russia, but we understand that it's not just about Ukraine and Russia. It's about world and Russia, Europe and America. So about the nuclear bomb, what we understand that it's pretty much not gonna happen because Russia knows, and our government already told that if they will be planning to do something, first of all, to use nuclear bomb, it's not so easy. It's absolutely not so easy, not just to, like to click the phone and to call me. No, it's the whole huge process. It's hundreds of people who are involved in that. Secondly, Americans...
In other words, just like our president, Putin cannot just get into a mood and decide to launch it on his own. There are checks and balances.
Absolutely.
We have, you know, military aides. There's a lot of people involved in that. So I guess that's one calming moment, if there can be one.
Yes, it is like that. Secondly, if this process is going to start, the world will see that. And Americans, not investigators, how do I say that? And Americans always see, and us always, we see what are they doing. And we have people who are informing us from Russia, so we do understand what's going on. It's not like just we are like sitting here and like with a, in a pink glasses, like, oh, what's going on? No, it's not like that. And the second, the most important thing, that Russia knows that we can attack as horrible as we only can, and they know that. Because Ukrainian government already told that to Russian government, and Russian government understand what Ukrainian government talking about. So if we gonna respond, gonna give feedback, it's gonna be super horrible for Russia. So they're not gonna do that. They can
now,
just.
Now the U.S. so far, Nadia, has sent, I think it's $1 billion worth of stuff, you know, with material and expertise that's not in and on the ground in Ukraine, we're told, and not the air cover and so forth, because there's a whole different debate on that. But once it gets to Ukraine, then we're not sure if it gets to where it's supposed to get in the supply chain. Do you feel confident that it gets to where it's supposed to go when what we do give gets there? Are you seeing it?
Well, I can't say for everything, every help, because it's like really a lot. But what I see and what I understand, that war is extremely expensive thing every day. For example, yesterday, my boys who I help, I have a lot of battalions I help by my personal financials, by volunteers' financials. Every day they go in a battle, day and night. And every second they are losing something, or they can take from Russian army some weapon, some tanks or wherever. So it's very expensive. For example, a week ago, I sent a new vehicle to boys. Right now, yesterday...
A new vehicle, yeah, to help with support for some of the men that were on the ground fighting in this. So there's a lot of great progress. I got to run because we're up against the break here, Nadia. Stay safe. I know it's going on 10 o'clock in the evening tonight over there, so... we'll check in again soon. All right, appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you.